What we don't want is the shocks. Government should not give shocks to the system. You know?
Sumal, why don't you define these shocks?
I'll define for my personal experience.
Yeah.
Engineering, construction was at 12% tax rate. And that was one of the main factors for me to even take it public.
Yeah.
Right, 12%. Overnight, they increased from 12% to 28%. That is a 150% straight increase. Then they put a 2% NBT on turnover. That works out to another 10%. Then the dividend tax, they increased to 14%. So overnight, I have to consider a 311% additional tax. How am I going to go to Dhammi can say, now you gave me a contract, now increase by 300%.
He might do that to make you happy.
Anybody can say.
Dinesh,
you know, that is
agree.
What I mean by shock.
No, but what do you think? The sometime is like a roller coastering effect. You know, sometime the government also need the money.
Yes,
you know,
yes, that I...
You know, but you know, if the country is rich, you know, they have to reduce. You know, that because of that temporary measurement, sometime, time to time, government have to do those kind of adjustment to get, you know, their revenue. Otherwise, this country cannot run. It's today's situation without increase the taxes and those kind of a thing, the government revenue is going to be $1,400 billion. You know?
The engine of growth, Dhammika. If the private sector is going to be the engine of growth, you can't take money from that and give it to inefficient public sector.
No, but only
it's simple as that. It's very simple. It's a very simple thing. You can't take from the efficient sector and give it to the inefficient sector. You know, will you take it? It's like us having a group of companies and all our profitable companies, we take the profit and keep alive some unprofitable subsidiary.
No, but
it's simple as that.
Thank you.
No,
but,
I don't agree.
No, but as a, not as a businessman,
the
because as a policy making level.
They all are not the engine of growth. If you say private sector is the engine of growth, then they must support that statement.
The same time, the private sector also have to grow. The government also have to balance their, you know, the cash flows. Because otherwise, country cannot run. As a policy maker, are you also involved in the previous government? Then I can understand as a businessman and the policy maker how to run the country. You know, because of that, we have to balance the both things. I know that private sector is unhappy, but...
I fully agree, but the 10,000 rupee increment they gave and not reducing the fuel prices was not called for. Nobody asked for it, you know. So then we are all now paying for it.
No, but sometimes the political, you know, end of the 5 years, they have to give something, no? You know?
I think you should run for presidency and I will support you fully.
Dhammika, do you have aspiration to be the common candidate?
No, okay. Because of that, you know, I am going through the every each detail, each ministry, because I can clearly see what we can do, you know, this reason. But actually, I will, you know, make the proposal for the all the 40 ministries.
Yeah, okay.
But if they're not doing within another 2 years, I will make a policy the papers. Okay.